Bobby Blue Eyes Johnson.
I realize that I'm the only person standing between you and lunch right now, so if someone could give me the green card in about 5 minutes, we should be ready to go. Thank you very much for the opportunity to give the invocation today. If you could please bow your heads. We thank you for the opportunity to come together during this winter TLI. The strength of Toastmasters is its members, not in numbers, but in our action. May each one here give and receive supportive coaching today so that we continue to develop and grow our leadership and communication skills. We thank you for this meal and the hands that prepared it. Please keep us safe during our travels home today. When we return, allow us to show integrity, respect, service, and excellence as we share the information we learned with the members back at our clubs to help make them healthy and successful. Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
At this time, we're going to start the buffet line, but please wait for a member of the wait staff to let you know when it's time for your table to go. Thank you. A wonderful meal, and this is continuing to be a great place for us to hold these great programs, these TLIs. At this time, I would like to introduce to you one more time our amazing program quality director, distinguished Toastmaster, Francine Milligan. Please give her a
hand. Thank you, Mr. Toastmaster. Is everyone enjoying their day so far?
Yes.
And just think, it's only half over. We have a great program lined up for you after lunch today with the elective sessions coming up and then your officer breakout trainings. But today wouldn't be possible if I didn't have a team of people to support me. And I must say that one thing I've learned in Toastmasters is how we need to have a strong team behind us to be a success. And delegation is key to being a good leader. Unfortunately, I'm not really good at that, but I'm working on it. It's something I still strive to do. But I was very, very excited and deeply grateful for our winter TLI chair, whose organization, dedication to detail, and her infectious, bubbly personality really helped make this program sing. So at this time, I'd like to welcome not only a great Toastmaster, but a wonderful friend, Advanced Communicator Bronze, Advanced Leader Bronze, Jessica Minard. Can I have a little token of appreciation for you? You can open it now if you want.
Now you want to see? It's upside down.
There's just one. Something that I know that you will use.
A new water bottle.
Yay! Jessica, at this time, I'd like to turn this over the podium over to you so that you can say a few words and thank you. Lectern. Thank you, Joe. Thank you, Joe. If anybody does not know Joe O'Keefe, he is a longtime Toastmaster, great friend, and also very good at protocol and correcting us between the difference between a lectern and a podium. Jessica?
Thank you very much, Francine. Thank you all so much for making this TLI such a momentous occasion for me. This is a huge undertaking, and I can't do it without a lot of people. I can't express to you the dedication, love, and hard work that went into doing it. It has been an honor to work with all of these people. Often you hear that it's difficult to get volunteers to do anything for you. We're a volunteer organization, but we're kind of different. Toastmasters do volunteer, and when they volunteer volunteer. We know we can always count on each other. I will not say this was without its challenges. It is a week after New Year's, people. All of the planning happened through the holidays, and this team of mine pulled it together and did a great job. I'd like to first introduce to you the first people you met as you walked in. Without the registration committee, my registration chair, Josh Dilley, and his team comprised of competent communicator John Albanini, Blaine Forkner, advanced communicator Bronze, and competent leader Karen Girardi, competent leader Lexi Patrick, Sarah Sowery, and a latecomer who will get his certificate later because I didn't know he was coming, Joel Cox. If all of you could please come up here, I thank you so much. Registration went so smoothly. When pulling off an event of this size. Signage, banners, microphones. He did an incredible job for me, and I'm so grateful. I would like to bring up now competent communicator, advanced leader Bronze, and our current district logistics manager, Jeff Coyne. Set on a tight timeline needs to run smoothly. For this reason, I'd like to thank competent communicator Ben Reynolds for being my stage manager. If you notice, everybody was queued up and ready to cross that stage today. That's why you're all eating lunch on time, people. That's the reason. You would have been left guessing what was coming up next and who those people were on stage. As far as Toastmasters go, I got the Toastmaster of the Year for my TLI Toastmaster. Please welcome competent communicator, advanced leader Silver, Jim McBriar. Presenters. Advanced Communicator Bronze, Advanced Leader Bronze, Rachel Kenyon, one of my best friends, was tasked with putting together a panel of presidents to present best practices to get to distinguished. Her choices of Distinguished Toastmaster Patty Thor, Competent Communicator Chad Hudson, and Competent Communicator Advanced Leader Bronze Pete Vandegome assured that you would have a broad spectrum of information. Did you enjoy their panel? Yes. I thought it was good. Could you all come up, please?
Little bit closer. There you go.
I was very, very disappointed when this next person was ill during the conference and was unable to give her tracks to DTF presentation. However, that just meant that I got the pleasure of having her at my TLI. Please welcome distinguished Toastmaster Sue Elvis. Today, we finally got a look at the new Pathways program that we've all been wondering about. I'd like to thank our past district governor, chief ambassador, distinguished Toastmaster, what a mouthful, Stephanie Scott. You know how we like to keep things on time, right? This is the second time I've mentioned you're eating lunch on time. I love it. Without a timer, we would not be on time. Please welcome Sammy Cortez. My cheeks are going to hurt by the end of the day from all the smiling. The day is not done, though. There are more people that will fill the rest of your afternoon with engaging and fulfilling presentations. These people put a ton of work into building their presentations and met my tight deadlines over the holidays, providing everything I needed to be sure that you got everything you needed. They will wow you in a few minutes, but they've been wowing me for a month. First up, I'd like to introduce to you our elective sessions. Please welcome the following people. Past District Governor, Distinguished Toastmaster, Mike Dalton. Past District Governor, Distinguished Toastmaster, Joe McBride. Distinguished Toastmaster, Don Michael. Distinguished Toastmaster, Nate Stevens. And Distinguished Toastmaster, Trevor Yanian. And lastly, the presenters of the officers training. Could you all come up at the same time, please? Advanced Communicator Bronze, Advanced Leader Bronze, Denise Etter. Confident Communicator, Advanced Leader Bronze, Mike Leonard. Distinguished Toastmaster, Carol McQuain. Advanced Communicator Bronze, Confident Leader, Amy Knoll. Confident Communicator, Verna Perry. Advanced
You can do that.
I'd also like to thank Bobby Blue Eyes, who is actually my cousin, believe it or not, and we would have never met again except that we were both in the same Toastmasters club. How weird is that?
That's awesome.
Bob Johnson, could you please come up for giving me the invocation? Certainly not least for me, the man behind this camera, the one on the tripod in the middle of the room, and our spring conference co-chair, Chris Sokolowski. Francine, for the opportunity to do this. I have grown and learned so much in this experience, and those of you who know me best know that this part of this does not scare me. It's the leadership that really does. So the High Performance Leadership Project that you guys are all looking for, find a TLI to chair, because you will earn it, man. Turn control back to Mr. Toastmaster. There are two more people that I would like to thank. One, unfortunately, is not with us today, but these people are really the heart and soul of our publicity, and that's our public relations manager, Alexis Sanders, and our webmaster and Eagle Eye editor, Wendy Gill. Alexis, would you please join me? To return control back to Mr. Toastmaster, Jim McBride.
And don't go too far away, because I think the last thing we have to do here is the trio is going to come back up one more time, so please welcome back Dr. Hollis Batista and Francine Milligan and Jennifer Sell.
Fantastic time.
Yeah.
Oh, let me hear it again. Woo! You haven't, so have I, and this is just the first half. Wait till the second half when you go through training and all of those wonder electives that you can choose to go to. I can't thank my program quality director enough. She spearheaded everything. Now, we do have very strong personalities in a good way. Yes, and we are a team, and also Jennifer. We are a trio. We really are Charlie's angels, because we work together as angels. So a big thank you to all of you and everyone else that participated this morning, and just for all of you for attending. You know, as a district director, it just makes me feel so good to see that each and every one of you, you're showing pride, because that's the thing. District 13 has pride. And thank you for showing me this today. Thank you. And now I'll give it to our program quality director, Distinguished Toastmaster Francine Milligan. Thank you, Madam District Director. I do have a couple of quick announcements to make and some awards to give. We talked a lot today about the Distinguished Club program and the incentives that Ms. Rachel Cannon reminded everybody of for the upcoming March cutoff of March 15th. If your club is distinguished or better, you'll receive $75 gift certificates to the TI store. And June 15th, it would be $50. But there was one right before that. We had offered $100 to any club that became distinguished or better by December 31st. And I am thrilled to say that we had not one, not two, but seven clubs become distinguished by December 31st. Have an officer from each one of these clubs please join me and accept their gift certificate. First, Venice Club. Charrington Toastmasters. Unfortunately, TI had already shut down for its year-end freeze, so I do owe this club their gift certificates, but please congratulate Women to Women. March 15th, and we will be presenting those awards at the Spring Conference, which is when?
April 7th.
April 7th or 9th, and where is it at?
State House.
State
announcement. It's just a clarification from this morning that I wanted to make. Chandra pointed this out to me, and I appreciate her bringing this to my attention. For the incentive that I was offering for the contest participation, the contest participation at the club level was for as many people to participate at the club level. Each club can only send one or two members to the area, depending on the size of your area. So in order to qualify for this incentive, I need to have your program from your club contest listing all the participants who participated, and you can still only send one or two people. So it's the number of people who participate at the club level. Chandra, again, thank you for making that clarification to me, making sure I made that correct at this point. As contestants. So I'm looking for clubs to get as many people to participate as contestants as possible. I would now like to turn control over to Distinguished Toastmaster, our current club growth director, Jennifer Sell. Thank you, Francine. And if you haven't figured out by now, I'm the quiet one. If you haven't seen already, because I was a little late getting them set up, there is marketing materials for your club, such as Toastmaster buttons, flyers, and brochures right outside the hallway, so make sure you stop there to get some things for your club. So who's ready now to be a club sponsor, mentor, or coach? Attend either Trevor's session for club coach, raise your hand, Trevor, or Dawn's for club coach or, club sponsor or mentor later today. And just don't forget about Talk Up Toastmasters, which runs from February 1st to March 31st to add 5 members to your club as well. I will now yield control to our Toastmaster.
Luncheon. Let's give another round of applause to all the leadership and the volunteers that have made today so successful. It really takes a village to make all of this happen, and Toastmasters really know how to step up. So it's now time for our afternoon sessions, and on page 6 of your program, you should find all of those different rooms. I hope you've selected where you'd like to go. And can somebody tell me the exact start time?
20 after.
Okay. One more quick announcement coming from Francine, and a reminder to turn in your name tags, and you'll be entered in to win to the conference.
One more quick announcement. My apologies, everyone. For the deck meeting, we will be in room 2303. That starts at 3:15 this afternoon after the officer training and the drawing for the spring conference registration. So again, for the business meeting, we will be in room 2303. Thank you, Jim.
Okay, it has been my honor to be your Toastmaster today. It's been a wonderful morning. Thank you very much. Everyone enjoy their sessions this afternoon. Thank you.